Is there a specific day of the week that you should buy stocks? Or what is the best time to sell stock? Is there a best time of the year to invest in stocks? People who have been in the market for a long time are used to the tough times and will know after large losses what's the best time, day, and month to invest in stocks. Welcome to our channel, Financial Insights, the place where you are always a little bit smarter and wiser after seeing one of our valuable videos so you can develop your financial knowledge. Don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to our channel so we can make even more financial content. When is the best time of the day to buy or sell stocks? Market volumes and rates can be erratic first thing in the morning. During the opening hours, the market takes into account all of the developments and news releases that have occurred since the previous closing bell, contributing to price volatility. A professional trader may be able to spot the right trends and profit quickly, but a less experienced trader may suffer significant losses as a result. If you're a beginner, you can avoid trading during these unpredictable hours, or at the very least, during the first hour. For experienced day traders, however, the first 15 minutes after the opening bell are peak trading time, with some of the largest trades of the day on the initial trends. The hour between 9:30 a.m. and 10:30 a.m. ET is also one of the best for day trading, with the biggest moves in the shortest period of time. Since volatility and volume begin to taper off about 11:30 a.m., many experienced day traders stop trading. As a consequence, trades take longer to complete and transfers are smaller with less volume. You can start day trading index features like the S&P 500 E-minis or an actively traded index exchange traded fund ETF like the S&P 500 SPDR, SPY as early as 8:30 a.m. pre-market and taper off around 10:30 a.m. Trading will go on until 11:30 a.m., much like bonds, but only if the market is still offering opportunities. The middle of the day trading is usually the calmest and most stable time of the day. People are waiting for more information to be released during this period. Since the majority of the day's news has already been factored into stock prices, many people are looking to see where the market will go for the rest of the day. Since rates are relatively steady during this period, it's a good time for a novice to trading because the activity is slower and the returns are potentially more consistent. Volatility and volume rise again in the final hours of the trading day. In reality, intraday stock market statistics suggest that the last hour can be similar to the first sharp reversals and large moves, particularly in the final minutes of trading. Day traders are often seeking to close out their positions between 3 and 4 p.m., or they could be attempting to enter a late day rally in the hopes that the momentum will carry forward to the next trading day. Is Monday the best day of the week to buy stock? Some people conclude that certain days deliver better returns than others systematically, but there is no evidence for such a market-wide impact in the long run. Even then, many people assume that Monday is the best day of the week. The Monday effect is what it's called. Traders say the stock market has a tendency to fall on Mondays, based on anecdotal evidence. Some assume this is due to the vast amount of negative news that is regularly published over the weekend. Others point to investors' pessimism about having to return to work, which is especially evident during Monday trading hours. The Monday impact has largely vanished for some reason. Nonetheless, if you're going to buy stocks, you might be better off doing so on Monday rather than any other day of the week, and you might find some good deals in the process. If Monday is the best to buy stock, then which day is the best to sell stocks? If Monday is the best day of the week to buy stocks, Friday is the best day to sell them before Monday's price drop. If you want a short sell, Friday could be the best day to do so if stocks are trading higher on Friday, and Monday will be the best day to cover your short. Fridays on the eve of three-day weekends are particularly good in the United States. The financial markets appear to grow ahead of these observed holidays due to generally optimistic sentiments prior to a long holiday weekend. Now that we know which day is the best to buy and sell stocks, let's see which month is ideal for buying and selling. Towards the end of the year, as well as during the summer months, the markets appear to see high returns. September is known for being a slow month. after record declines of 19.7% and 21.5% in 1929 and 1987. The average return in October is positive historically. The following graph illustrates the S&P 500's monthly average returns from 1928 to 2017. As a result, a trader might consider investing heavily in the stock market in September when prices start to decline in order to be ready for the October bump up. There's also a phenomenon known as the January effect. According to Jeremy J. Siegel's book, Stocks for the Long Run, The Definitive Guide to Financial Market Returns and Long-Term Investing Strategies, investors return to equity markets with a vengeance at the start of the new year, driving up prices, particularly of small cap and value stocks. However, as more detail about such possible anomalies becomes available, the effect begins to fade. The January effect is a theory that claims that stock prices fall in December and then rise in January. Meanwhile, the October effect refers to the assumption that stock prices appear to decline in October. Business analysts, on the other hand, contend that the January and October effects no longer have a major impact on the stock market. Not to mention, the end of December has proven to be a good time to buy small caps or value stocks in order to be ready for a rally early the following month. Another benefit is that many investors begin selling stocks in large amounts at the end of the year, especially those that have fallen in value, in order to assert capital losses on their tax returns. So, once again, the final days of the year's trading will have some bargains. There isn't a single day of the month that is always the best time to purchase or sell. Stocks, on the other hand, have a tendency to grow at the beginning of each month. This pattern is primarily due to monthly new money flows geared toward mutual funds. Furthermore, fund managers try to make their balance sheets look nice at the end of the quarter by buying stocks that have performed well during that period. In the middle of the month, stock prices begin to decline. So, for example, a trader could profit from buying stocks near the month's midpoint, from the 10th to the 15th. The best time to sell stocks is possibly within the 5 days following the month's turn. Takeaway: any advice given above about the best time of day, week, or month to buy and sell stocks should be viewed as a broad generalization rather than a hard and fast law. If you keep an eye on the stock market over time, you'll notice a lot of expectations to the previously listed general guidelines. Depending on news events and changing business dynamics, there are several expectations and anomalies. The closest thing to a hard and fast law is that the first and last hours of a trading day are the busiest, with the most opportunities, but many traders benefit in the middle of the day as well. Nonetheless, academic evidence indicates that any market timing trends that enable one to reliably produce abnormal returns are short-lived, as these opportunities are quickly arbitraged away and markets become more productive as traders and investors become more aware of the patterns. This variation occurs because stock market movements, like individual stock prices, are influenced by a variety of variables and thus do not always obey clear laws. In reality, many price changes occur as a result of major news events and other unpredictably occurring factors that may not be recognized on a regular basis. Also, bear in mind that when new timing trends emerge in the stock market, smart money can easily find a way to profit from them. As a consequence, any profits derived from exploiting such a pattern could quickly dwindle. The first and last hours of every trading day are almost always the busiest. Those time frames can offer various trading opportunities, but the periods in between can also be profitable to trade on any given day. Type stocks in the comments below if you are going to buy stocks. Thank you for watching, follow us on Instagram, and make sure to subscribe and check out our other valuable videos. See you soon at Financial Insights.